Let's now turn to the concept of systemic risk. It's usually a good idea to start with a definition. What do we mean by systemic risk? Several oversight bodies and academicians have come up with some definitions. All of them have two common components, which are highlighted. First, that risks arise for the financial system as a whole, meaning the risks affect multiple financial institutions or markets at the same time or are interrelated in some way. For instance, banks often lend their excess checking account deposits, those they can't use immediately, to other banks for short-term needs. If several banks suffered an unexpectedly high withdrawal of deposits and, as a result, could not return the money they had borrowed from other banks, this would constitute a systemic risk event in the interbank market. Such an event occurred in the fall of 2008. A second common component of systemic risk is that it has an impact on economic activity. Sometimes economists refer to this impact as on the real economy, where real goods and services are produced, to distinguish it from the monetary side of the economy, where financial transactions take place. So, for example, the impact of a systemic banking event in which banks as a whole reduce their mortgage loans to households who want to buy houses would negatively affect the construction industry, the real estate industry, and the demand for new appliances and new furniture, and so on, the real economy. To be able to thwart systemic risks with policies and regulation, oversight bodies and regulators have found it useful to consider two components of systemic risk, the time series component and the cross-sectional or structural component. For simplicity, we'll call the second one just the cross-sectional component. The time series component refers to risks that develop over time, resembling a cycle, not unlike a business cycle. The cross-sectional component refers to the notion that multiple institutions or markets face difficulty nearly simultaneously, and one default can lead to multiple defaults, like a domino effect.